Once upon a time, in a faraway land, a young prince lived in a shining castle. Although he had everything his heart desired, the prince was selfish and unkind. But then, one winter's night, an old beggar woman came to the castle for shelter from the bitter cold. Repulsed by her haggard appearance, the prince turned the old woman away. But she warned him not to be deceived by appearances, for beauty is found within. And when he dismissed her again, the old woman's ugliness melted away to reveal a beautiful enchantress. The prince tried to apologize, but it was too late, for she had seen that there was no love in his heart. And as punishment, she transformed him into a hideous beast and placed a powerful spell on the castle and all who lived there. The rose she had offered was truly an enchanted rose. If he could learn to love another and earn their love in return by the time the last petal fell, then the spell would be broken. If not, he would be doomed to remain a beast for all time. As the years passed, he fell into despair and lost all hope. For who could ever learn to love a beast?
Little town, it's a quiet village. Every day like the one before. Little town full of little people, waking up to say
bonjour,
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 bonjour.
There goes the baker with his tray, like always, the same old bread and rolls to sell. Every morning just the same, since the morning that we came to this poor provincial town.
Good morning, Belle.
Good morning, monsieur. I just finished the most wonderful story.
That's nice. Marie, the baguettes. Hurry up.
Look, there she goes. That girl is strange, no question. Dazed and distracted, can't you tell?
They're a part of any crowd.
With her head upon some cloud.
She's a funny girl to have.
Bonjour.
Good day.
How is your family?
Bonjour.
Good day.
How is your wife?
I need 6 eggs.
That's too expensive.
There must be more than this provincial life.
Look, there she goes. That girl is so peculiar. I wonder if she's feeling well.
With a dreamy, far-off look.
And her nose stuck in a book.
What a puzzle to the rest of us is now.
Isn't this amazing? It's my favorite part, because you'll see here's where she meets Prince Charming, but she won't discover that it's him till chapter 3.
But behind that fair facade, I'm afraid she's rather odd. Very different from the rest of us.
She's nothing like the rest of us. She's different from the rest of us. She's dead.
Wow, you didn't miss a shot, Gaston. You're the greatest hunter in the whole world.
I know.
No beast alive stands a chance against you, and no girl for that matter.
It's true, LeFou, and I've got my sights set on that one. She's the one. The lucky girl I'm going to marry.
But she...
The most beautiful girl in town.
I know,
and that makes her the best. And don't I deserve the best?
But of course, I mean you do, but I...
Right from the moment when I met her, saw her, I said she's gorgeous and I fell. Here in town there's only she who is beautiful as me. So I'm making plans to woo and marry Belle.
Gaston, oh, he's so cute. Be still, my heart, I'm hardly breathing.
like to thank you all for coming to my wedding. First, I better go in there and propose to the girl. Unifu.
Oh, I know. I strike up the band.
Not yet.
Sorry.
I'm just full of surprises. You know, Belle, there's not a girl in town who wouldn't love to be in your shoes. This is the day your dreams come true.
What do you know, Gaston?
Plenty. Here, picture this. A rustic hunting lodge, my latest kill roasting on the fire, and my little wife massaging my feet, while the little ones play on the floor with the dogs. Oh, we'll have 6 or 7.
Dogs?
No, Belle. Strapping boys like me.
Imagine that.
Do you know who that little wife will be? You, Belle.
Gaston, I really don't know what to say.
Say you'll marry me.
I'm very sorry, Gaston, but... I just don't deserve you.
Whoa!
So, how'd it go?
I'll have Belle for my wife. Make no mistake about that.
Can you imagine? He asked me to marry him. Me, the wife of that boorish, brainless... Philippe, what are you doing here? Where's Papa? Where is he, Philippe?
Who does she think she is? That girl has tangled with the wrong man. No one says no to Gaston. Dismissed, rejected, publicly humiliated. Why, it's more than I can bear.
More beer?
What for? Nothing helps. I'm disgraced.
Who, you? Never. Gosh, it disturbs me to see you, Gaston, looking so down in the dumps. Every guy here'd love to be you, Gaston, even when taking your lumps. There's no man in town as admired as you. You're everyone's favorite guy. Everyone's awed and inspired by you, and it's not very hard to see why. No one's slick as Gaston, no one's quick as Gaston, no one's next as incredibly thick as Gaston, for there's no man in town half as manly, perfect, a pure paragon. You can ask any Tom, Dick, or Stanley, and they'll tell you whose team they prefer to be on.
No one's been like Gaston, or King been like Gaston.
No one's got a swell cleft in his chin like Gaston.
As a specimen, yes, I'm intimidating.
I want a guy like Gaston. No one fights like Gaston, doesn't like Gaston.
In a wrestling match, nobody fights like Gaston.
For there's no one as curly and brawny.
As you see, I've got biceps to spare.
Not a bit of him scraggly or scrawny.
That's right. And every last inch of me's covered with hair.
No one hits like Gaston.
Matches with like Gaston.
In a spitting match, nobody spits like Gaston.
I'm especially good at expectorating.
10 points for Gaston.
When I was a lad, I ate 4 dozen eggs every morning to help me get large.
And now that I'm grown, I eat 5 dozen eggs, so I'm roughly the size of a barge.
Goes tromping around wearing boots like Gaston.
I use antlers in all of my decorating.
Gaston!
Help! Someone help me!
Maurice?
Please, please, I need your help. He's got her locked in the dungeon.
Who?
Belle, we must go. Not a minute to lose.
Whoa, slow down, Maurice. Who's got Belle locked in a dungeon?
A beast! A horrible, monstrous beast!
Is it a big beast, you?
And sharp, cruel fangs?
Yes, yes. Will you help me?
All right, old man. We'll help you out.
You will? Oh, thank you, thank you, thank you!
Crazy old Maurice.
He's always good for a laugh.
Sir, the girl has lost her father and her freedom all in one day.
You fall in love with her, she falls in love with you, and poof, the spell is broken. We'll be human again.
Oh, it's not that easy, Lumiere. These things take time.
But the rose has already begun to wilt.
You can start by making yourself more presentable. Straighten up. Try to act like a gentleman.
Ah, yes. Give her a dashing, debonair smile. Come, come, show me the smile. Here she is.
Good evening. The girl, yes, the girl. Well, actually, she's in the process of circumstances being what they are. Your Grace, Your Eminence.
Let's go, Beastie.
Come out, Rob.
Master, I could be wrong, but that may not be the best way to win the girl's affections.
Please, attempt to be a gentleman.
But she is being so difficult.
Gently, gently.
Suave, genteel.
Join me for dinner.
Please.
No, thank you.
Then go ahead and starve! If she doesn't eat with me, then she doesn't eat at all.
Oh, dear. That didn't go very well at all, did it?
Lumiere, stand watch at the door and inform me at once if there is the slightest change.
You can count on me, mon capitaine.
Well, you might as well go downstairs.
Ma chère mademoiselle, it is with deepest pride and greatest pleasure that we welcome you tonight. And now, we invite you to relax. Let us pull up a chair as the dining room proudly presents your dinner. Be our guest. Be our guest. Put our service to the test. Tie your napkin round your neck, sherry, and we provide the rest. Soup du jour, hot hors d'oeuvre. Why, we only live to serve. Try the gray stuff. It's delicious. Don't believe me? Ask the dishes. They can sing, they can dance. After all, miss, this is France. And a dinner here is never second best. Go on, unfold your menu. Take a glance and then you'll be our guest. We our guest, be our guest.
Beef ragu, cheese souffle, pie and pudding
on flambé. We'll prepare and serve with flair a culinary cabaret. You're alone and you're scared, but the banquet's all prepared. No one's gloomy or complaining while the flatware's entertaining. We tell jokes, I do tricks with my fellow candlesticks.
Put it all in perfect taste that you can bear. Come on and lift your glass, you've won your own free pass. Be our guest.
If you're stressed, it's fine dining we suggest.
Be our guest, be our guest, be our guest.
It's a guest, thanks a lot, but I'll be blessed. Wine's important, thank the Lord, I bet the napkin's freshly pressed. With the food, she'll want tea, and my dear, that's fine with me. While the cups do this, I'll shoo it, I'll be bubbling, I'll be brewing. I'll get warm, I've been hot. Heaven's sake, is that a stop? Clean it up, we want to come. got a lot to do. Is it one love or two? For you, our guest.
He's our guest.
I don't usually leave the asylum in the middle of the night, but he said you'd make it worth my while. I'm listening.
It's like this. I've got my heart set on marrying Belle, but she needs a little persuasion.
Turned him down flat.
Everyone knows her father's a lunatic. He was in here tonight raving about a beast in a castle.
Maurice is harmless.
The point is, Belle would do anything to keep him from being locked up.
Yeah, even marry him.
So you want me to throw her father into the asylum unless she agrees to marry you? Oh, that is despicable. I love it.
As old as time, true as it can be, barely even friends, then somebody bends unexpectedly. Just a little change, small to say the least, both a little scared, neither one prepared. Beauty and the Beast. Ever just the same, ever a surprise. Ever as before, ever just as sure as the sun will rise. Tale as old as time, tune as old as song, bittersweet and strange, finding you can change, learning you were wrong. Certain as the sun, rising in the east, tale as old as time, song as old as rhyme. Beauty and the Beast. Tale as old as time, song as old as rhyme. Beauty and the Beast.
Off to the cupboard with you now, Chip. Good night, love.
I know he looks vicious, but he's really kind and gentle.
If I didn't know better, I'd think you had feelings for this monster.
He's no monster, Gaston. You are.
The Beast will make off with your children. He'll come after them in the night. We're not safe till his head is mounted on my wall. I say we kill the Beast.
We're not safe until he's dead. He'll come stalking us at night.
Said to sacrifice our children to his monstrous appetite.
He'll wreak havoc on our village if we let him wander free.
So it's time to take some action, boys. It's time to follow me. Through the mist, through the wood,
nights through the darkness and the shadows. It's a nightmare, but it's one exciting ride. Say a prayer, then we're there at the drawbridge of a castle, and there's something truly terrible inside. It's a beast. He's got fangs, razor sharp ones, massive paws, killer claws for the feast. Hear him roar, see him foam, but we're not coming home till he's dead. Good and dead! Kill the beast!
No.
You're not with us, you're against us. Bring the old man.
Get your hands off me.
We can't have them running off to warn the creature.
Let us out.
We'll rid the village of this beast. Who's with me?
I am.
Let's your push, mount your horse.
Through your courage to the sticking place.
We're counting on Gaston to lead the way.
Through a mist, through a wood, right within the haunted castle, something lurking that you don't see every day. It's a beast, for as tall as a mountain. We will rest till he's good and he's free. Sally forth, sally home, grab your sword, grab your bow, make the Lord and hear him go.
Maybe it would have been better if she'd never come at all. Could it be?
Is it she?
Sacre bleu! Invaders!
Encroachers!
And they have the mirror.
Warn the master. If it's a fight they want, we'll be ready for them. Who's with me?
Fly, my pretties, fly, fly!
At least, I got to see you one last time.
No, I love you.
Just as
Sometimes our happiness is captured. Somehow a time and place stand still. Love lives on inside our hearts and always will. Minutes turn to hours, days to years then gone. But when all else has been forgotten, still our song lives on. Maybe some moments weren't so perfect, maybe some memories not so sweet, but we have to know some bad times or our lives are incomplete. Then when the shadows overtake us, just when we feel all hope is gone, we'll hear our song and no one's more.